Northam campaign look like the racist. They ran against him. You're a racist. Trump's a racist. And he's the guy in blackface.
This is what some Democrats do. They call the president racist. They call, in this case, Ed Gillespie a racist, when in fact the governor himself is the one who's the racist because of this yearbook.
Yeah, remember they ran this awful ad against
Gillespie? This ad was minority kids. There were Hispanics. There were Muslim kids with headdress. And this pickup truck with a Gillespie bumper sticker and a Confederate flag on the back. And it
really
looked like a Trump Gillespie supporter was trying to run over immigrant kids. It was disgusting and despicable, especially since it was supporting a Democrat who turns out to be a racist.
Amazing that a kid smirks with a MAGA hat on and everybody finds that so offensive. And this, people are upset, but not as upset as they were then. Ed, thank you.
Appreciate it.
Got it wrong. Advice for journalists. That is the subject of tonight's Waters Words. The Democrat Party is moving towards the extreme left. One of the reasons is because the media won't ask Democrats a direct question. Democrats are never forced to defend their radical positions. The media frames the issue this way. Check out the Washington Post headline. Republicans seize on liberal positions to paint Democrats as radical. So here are the questions that journalists should be asking Democrats if they claim to be unbiased. Let's begin with global warming.
Climate change is the existential threat of our time.
This could be the number one problem in America if we continue to allow power to concentrate and with corporations to dictate the quality of our air, to dictate the fact and tell us that we can keep burning fossil fuels, to dupe us. People will die.
Reporters asked Democrats, do you believe climate change is the number one threat facing America? Do you believe climate change is more of a threat than terrorism, nuclear war, China, opioids? How many Americans has climate change killed? Do you want to eliminate oil and gas from the U.S. economy? Because that's the goal of your Green New Deal. Try that. Next up, partial birth abortion. Here's testimony from a late-term abortion bill sponsor in Virginia.
Where it's obvious that a woman is about to give birth, she has physical signs that she is about to give birth, would that still be a point at which she could request an abortion if she was so certified? She's dilating.
Mr. Chairman, that would be a decision that the doctor, the physician, and the woman.
I understand that. I'm asking if your bill allows that.
My bill would allow that, yes.
Wow. So, reporters, ask the Democrats this. Do you support partial birth abortion? Are you comfortable with a woman delivering a baby and then the doctor terminating it? All right, next up, tax hikes. Here's Democrat Congresswoman Omar from Minnesota.
There are a few things that we can do. One of them is that we could increase the taxes that people are paying, who are the extremely wealthy in our community. So 70%, 80%, we've had it as high as 90%.
90%. All right, Democrats, take a question from a reporter like this. Just, I dare you. Do you support a 90% tax rate? What do you think taxes should be raised to? 50%? 60%? 70%? Now, if I was a journalist, I would demand they give me a number. Next up, socialized health care. Presidential candidate Kamala Harris said this.
For people out there who like their insurance, they don't get to keep it.
Well, listen, the idea is that everyone gets access to medical care. And you don't have to go through the process of going through an insurance company, having them give you approval, going through the paperwork, all of the delay that may require. Who of us has not had that situation where you got to wait for approval and the doctor says, well, I don't know if your insurance company is going to cover this? Let's eliminate all of that.
Eliminate all of it. Reporters asked Democrats this. Do you support single-payer health care? Ask all of them that. Do you agree with Kamala Harris that we should get rid of the healthcare industry in America? Do you want to take away the private healthcare plans of 175 million Americans and give them a government plan? How would you pay for all this? Raising everyone's taxes still won't cover it. Next up, the wall. Here's Pelosi.
to put a wall there is to, in my view, ineffective, too expensive, almost immoral.
So reporters ask Democrats this question. If walls are immoral, should we tear down the existing walls that we have now on the border? And if walls don't work, why did the walls erected in Yuma and San Diego cause border arrests to drop 80% and 90%? So there's my advice for reporters. Just ask Democrats simple, direct, and logical questions. And make them go on the record and hold them accountable. And if you journalists want to need more advice, call me.